She's fast, she's furious, and she knows what to do when there's a snake on a plane.
I'm very, very brave.
I got big, too.
Elsa Pataky is a Spanish movie star, queen of Byron Bay, and married into Australia's first family of Hollywood. After getting her start in Spanish soaps,
I don't deserve it.
Elsa smashed into the Fast franchise alongside The Rock and made a splash as the half-human, half-siren leader in Tidelands.
I am your queen.
Now she's taking over as the family action star in Interceptor.
You want this room? Come and get it.
Where her character finds herself in the middle of a nuclear attack on a missile base in the Pacific Ocean. Talk about a rough day at work.
You plan for every possible outcome, but you couldn't plan for me.
And Elsa Pataky joins us now! Elsa, thank you very much for joining us. Wonderful to have you on the show again. Congrats on the movie. This is action-packed. You are saving the world from a nuclear attack. And I know that you're a fitness fanatic. You're obviously ready for a physical role, but how much training was involved for you to pull off this character?
It was a lot of training, yeah. I knew how much work it is to do an action movie because I've seen Chris, how hard he works in these movies. So we started like 5 months with like full-on military train. We just started with all the training for the fights, which is like guys, the 6 fights in the movie, more or less like 800 moves that you have to memorize and do it again. So every day we were like there for like maybe 4 hours a day, just going through it. Like it's all like a choreography. So you have to know all the moves have to be in your head because if you miss one, you kind of have to start again. So it's just like all of these tag, you just punch, you keep going. Yeah, so it's a lot in your head.
And unlike choreography, if you do a wrong step, you get punched in the head.
Yeah. It's danger. The stakes are high.
Yeah, you do. If you miss one and you don't do the right move, it will get you. And like I was doing almost all my scenes like with they were stunt specialists, so they know what they were doing. So if I missed it, it was like always my fault, so I will get them.
Elsa, a lot of actors go on, they bang on about they want a dramatic role, they want, you know, they want all that kind of the acclaim that comes with dramatic roles. But be serious, how much fun is it to be an action hero?
It's so much fun. It's as fun as when you watch them.
Wow.
I really enjoy it. Like I enjoy the whole process. I know it's really hard and I was like really tired at the end of the days. But I grew up watching these movies. I grew up watching the Indiana Jones movies with my dad and I always wanted to be that female Indiana Jones. So I was like, well, it's a little bit late, but can you do it? It was like, it was a real challenge for me. But I really enjoy the process actually. A lot.
And it looks amazing. He doesn't like Die Hard on the ocean. It's incredible. And your husband, Chris, you mentioned, is an executive producer on the movie. But tell the truth, who was boss on the set?
He's so bossy.
He was.
No, he was just telling me, like, this is the right angle when you punch. He was just showing me all how you have to do it, what is the right, you know, position that you have to have. Like, he's been doing it for, like, a long time. So it was great having him, and he was supporting me since the beginning when he read the scripts, like, you need to do this. It's going to be fun. You're going to enjoy it. I know how much you like these kind of movies and how destroyed you will be after. You won't do it again.
Talk about him being bossy and teaching you how to fight. Can you teach us? What's the perfect way to throw a pretend punch?
With a punch? Oh, yeah, like, it depends on, like, the kind of punch. But you have to be high, like, and really, like, do the movements, like, really bigger.
Okay.
Usually when you real fight, it's just much quicker. But you, for the camera, everything has to be bigger and more exaggerated in a way. So you see in the camera can capture it. So, okay. Yeah, it has its tricks.
Georgie, fake punch while lead right now.
Okay.
Just,
yeah,
just,
ready,
here we go. Yeah. Elsa, you can judge.
It has to be really big.
Okay, go.
Okay, ready?
Right.
Oh, wow.
I was actually, Elsa, I'm
it was
so
great.
Uncoordinated that I actually thought I may hit him.
Oh, that fake. that just fake hurt so much.
Elsa, she's been wanting to do that for a long time.
I'm sure you had the opportunity. Yeah, right there.
Hey, talking of working with people, so obviously you worked with your husband, but that can be a bit dicey. So how did you two get on, or when you had differences you had to resolve, how did that work out?
No, it's like a marriage, you know, in the way you work it out things. And no, it was great. And also it's different, like, I think, with executive producer in a way, you know, it gives you advice, it kind of like supports you. It's even easier than when we're married every day, right?
Okay, all right. But here's a classic actress question, because Chris was the EP on it. Were you his first choice?
I mean, did you ask? I was ready to just like go like that.
Yes.
I was almost threatening him, like, if he didn't get me for that role, I was just like, there will be.
Yes. Yes. Good.
Interceptor is in select cinemas May 26 and out June 3 on Netflix. Elsa Pataky, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.